This Java Voice Quick Start covers both inbound and outbound voice calls. We're going to be using the code from a guide you can find in the Twilio docs. There are links down in the description if you want to follow along. To make a phone call, you need a phone number, so let's go get one. We'll start in the phone number console, and I'll search for a 267 area code number, and I'll buy the first Philadelphia area phone number I find. I'll click buy this number, and then setup number. We'll come back to phone number setup later. Let's start by talking about outbound calls. Your app makes a post request to Twilio. Twilio places a call to your phone. When the call's connected, Twilio requests some TwiML instructions from your application. If the TwiML looks like this, then Twilio speaks some text back to your phone. Let's write some code to make that work. I'm using Eclipse. Inside of Eclipse, I'll create a new Gradle project that I'll call make and receive calls. We'll click finish. Once that's done being set up, we'll open up the build.gradle file where we can specify the dependencies for our project. The first dependency that we need is a logging framework called SLF4J that the Spark Web Framework uses under the hood. Then we'll pull in the Spark Web Framework itself that we'll use for handling post requests, and then we'll pull in the Twilio helper library. Once the dependencies are specified, we can refresh the Gradle project, which will bring them in to the project. Now we'll create a new class that we'll place in a package called com.twilio that we'll call makeCall, and I'll give it a main function. Inside of makeCall.java, the first thing we need to do is import some namespaces. We need the URI and URI syntax exception classes, as well as the Twilio call and phone number objects from the Twilio helper library. Our main function could throw a URI syntax exception, so we'll specify that there. Then we need some credentials from our Twilio account. Namely, we need the account SID and the auth token that we use to authenticate our Twilio account. You can find those inside of the Twilio console. These values will look something like this, but I've got these stored in environment variables for safekeeping, so let's get them from there instead using system.getenv. I'll pull the Twilio account SID and the Twilio auth token out of my environment. Next, we'll use those two credentials to initialize the Twilio REST client. So I pass in the account SID and the auth token. Now we're ready to create that outbound call. So we'll use call.creator. This is going to take a couple of phone numbers as a parameter. The first one is going to be the two phone number. That's going to be my phone number, which I have stored inside of an environment variable as well. So we'll pull that in. Then the second phone number that it's going to take is going to be the Twilio phone number that we purchased earlier in the phone number console, so I'll paste that in. The last thing we need here is a URI. This is going to be to some TwiML. So this is going to be demo.twilio.com/docs/voice.xml. This TwiML will execute when the call is connected. Finally, we'll call create on the creator, and we will print out to the console the call's ID when it connects, just so that we know it was connected. We'll save it, and we'll give our project a run, and a call will be placed to my cell phone.
Thanks for trying our documentation. Enjoy.
That's great, Twilio. Who doesn't love a Rickroll? Let's check out the TwiML to see how that happened. There's a say that does text-to-speech and reads out, thanks for trying our documentation, enjoy, and then a play tag that plays that lovely, classic Rickroll MP3. Now let's talk about inbound calls. User places a phone call to your Twilio number. Twilio makes an HTTP request to your app, which returns some TwiML. And if the TwiML looks like this, then Twilio speaks some text back to the user. Let's write the server code to make that happen. To handle our inbound call, we'll create a new Java class called receiveCall, and we'll give it a main function as well. We'll import the Spark Web Framework's post function so that we can create a post route for Twilio to reach out to. And then we'll pull in the say and voice response objects from the Twilio helper library's TwiML classes. Now we'll create a post request called receive-call. And in here, we'll create a voice response object, which will hold the TwiML that Twilio will reach out for when the incoming call is connected. We'll use the voice response builder and create a say response. This will do text to speech, and it'll read out, hello from your pals at Twilio, have fun. We'll give that a build, and then we'll build the response builder. And then we'll return the XML representation of our voice response, since TwiML is just XML. We'll run the project, and you'll see that it fires up on localhost port 4567. Twilio can't reach localhost port 4567, so we use ngrok to create an HTTP tunnel on port 4567 to get a publicly addressable URL that we can take to the phone number console and paste in where it says a call comes in webhook and add receive-call. Once we save the phone number, I can pull out my cell phone and make a call back to our Twilio phone number so that we can hear that text-to-speech response coming from Twilio.
Hello from your pals at Twilio. Have fun.
We will have fun because now we know how to handle phone calls using Java with Twilio.